Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. Let's go to 2-Dash Fortress here. That's how they abbreviate it, so what else can I call it there? And let's go face Roy for the first time. Dun dun. Dun dun. I'm pretty sure this door leads over to that left door over there. Yeah, I think so. Oh, I know what this is. This is one of those... Yeah, you lean this and you go that way. Surprisingly, when you tilt to the right, it goes to the left and vice versa. Let's collect blue coins! Woo! Oh, shoot! That was useless. Can I get that? Aw, oh, missed one coin. I wanted an audience applause, but whatever. That is that, I guess. No real secrets in there other than coins, if you really care about them. I'm pretty sure there's a door hidden. Yep, that's what I thought. I think this is where the first star coin is. No? Guess not. Ah, my memory fails me once again. Ooh, propeller mushroom. Must get... Dang it, not a star! Well, I suppose I can use that just to climb the tower a little faster than having to wait for, Chattery Bones over there to do so. Yeah, you can get these coins just by going through the wall like that as well. Star coins? No, I didn't think so. I'm looking for hidden areas in the wall, in case you don't realize that. Like other castles, this place has got hidden areas and stuff like that, of course. And you also notice that there was a random magic blast there. That's Roy shooting his magic wand at you. Poorly, may I add. His magic blasts are really slow, and as you can see, they're not really fast enough to really frighten you. And that one just seemed to, like, appear right on the screen. I don't know, that's just what it looked like in my vision. Because I just, like, caught it out of the corner of my eye, and yeah. And through the door we go! To the second area of the fortress. Anything in here? No. Checkpoint there. Anything in here? Star coin number 2! Yeah! Whenever you see a different colored wall like that, that usually means that you can go through it. That's really all there is to say about that. That usually I say. It's not a drool, so to speak. You know, not a rule that it's always gonna be like that, but most of the time it is, I would say. And, can I get up there, please? Thank you, Mario. Can I wall kick off this side? Yes, I can. And I can also land right in the spikes. That's awesome. Wait. Is there something up here? Oh, there's that. I didn't expect to find that when I mentioned something. I would like to use your body to get up there, but I would also like to avoid ye old magic blast. Can I get... Yeah, there is something up there. Just a bunch of coins, though. It just looked suspicious there because of the... Ow! Because of the different colored blocks there. Just saying, or the pattern of the blocks. I don't know why that looked suspicious to me, but it did, and it was successful. Ooh, but I do see a secret. There's a door right here. See that square of red blocks or brownish blocks there? Yeah. It's a red coin challenge. Just on point. I hope I don't screw this up. Knowing me, I will, though. Or not. Successful PkGam is successful and gets a fire flower for his trouble. And one more coin to go. I'm not positive where it is, but I shall soon find out. I don't really care it's in that box. Probably a power-up. I see that coin! That is so well hidden, no one would ever find it. And let's just go up here, climb across these fences, and into the door. So this place is cleared out nicely. And so, we face the boss of the fortress. Roar, indeed. And he's got that ground pound thing. I'm pretty sure that stuns you if you're on the ground when he touches the ground, when he does his ground pound thing. Let's test that out. Yeah, it does stun you. So that's an earthquake effect thing there. And let's just do that. So I was right about something for once. Yay! Come on, pop out of your shell there. There we go. You're dead. This level is done. Mario's happy. And he's boasting that he's number one. Huh? Rawr! Okay, I was way too early with my timing on that rawr there. Man, how did he get into that castle? He just went right through the wall! Huh. Magical. I guess I could do that 1-up minigame as long as it's on my path to 2-4 over there. And, oh, there's a toad in distress there. I really don't feel like rescuing them. They aren't essential for getting 100%. So I'm just gonna leave them be since they're kind of, you know, out of the way. I mean, I already completed the level. Why complete it again just for a few 1-ups and the new toad house? Maybe I'll do them off camera if I need items or something like that. But otherwise, I'm not gonna do so. Okay, here we go. And no, you can't jump at the balloons to get their 1-up goodness. So let's try and line these up. Oh, good run! 4 1-ups! I almost got all 6. And now let's go to 2-4. I was gonna say 4-2. I guess my numbering system or my number thoughts are off today. Whatever. Here we go! 2-4. This one's got a secret exit. Secret exit's pretty tricky to find. In fact, it had me stuck for the longest time. On my first playthrough, you need a propeller mushroom to get it as well. You also need the propeller mushroom for a bunch of the star coins in this one too. So the propeller mushroom is the gimmick of the level. If you get this turtle shell and throw it at these blocks, it'll go through a little turtle obstacle course there and get you some coins. You'll notice that there's wind in this one. That pushes you forward, obviously. There's also coins that fly with the wind magically somehow. And you can use power blocks to knock them out of the air. And oh, cheap secret coming up soon. Go up to here. And up here, yeah, there is a vine. Who is gonna think of that? Tell me! Anyway. This is a very, very stupid coin block maze thingy here. See, you have to find the opening here, and needless to say, you can't just, like, fly your way up to there, because there's a bunch of coins in your way. Well, that works for me. Can I just, like, can I go right through the ceiling? No, no, come on. Like, to be successful PkGam again. Can I just, like, spin? No. Oh, there's a 1-up over there. Can I get that at least? Yes, I can. What's... where are the holes in this place? Jesus! This is silly. This is 1-block holes? Wow. Okay, I'm gonna just spin up and off the screen until I get to this corner. There we go. That's a lot of invisible blocks. And... oh, this is right where I was before. I was a little worried that I was gonna die or something there. I don't know why. I don't know if the game... I don't know why I would feel the game would be that cheap. I don't know if it's because the secrets are that cheap or something like that. I don't know. There's another Koopa coin obstacle course there if you want to throw a shell into that structure. Any pipes to go down? No. There's turtles dancing to the music, though. Wah, wah. And I'll just wait for the wind to stop just to be safe. There we go. I don't want to go down there, honestly, to see what's in those boxes. I do think I have to go into that pipe, though, over there, and that's what I'm gonna do. I'm pretty sure you need a propeller mushroom for this coin. Yep, see where it is? In this flower-shaped coin area here. Oh boy, this one's a little bit scary to get. You gotta low jump and then spin! Oh! Let's try that again. I'm not too far away from that coin area, but I do need a propeller mushroom to get that. So, I don't... oh, there it is right there. Poopers. Well, what's in here anyway? Now that I have the opportunity to do so. Well, there's a 1-up there. That's probably the only prize. Well, you know what? I'll just go through this level to do the normal exit, and then I'll come back for the coins and the secret exit, because I'm going to have to do 2 runs through this level anyway. I'm trying to multitask way too much here in this level, so let's just take one thing at a time. And I should have thrown that barrel down here at the Koopas, dang it. And there's a mushroom there, I could definitely use that. And, oh, I want to get up on that ladder. Oh, whenever the wind is blowing, you can't climb these rope ladders. It'll just knock you right off. Wait. You need the propeller mushroom for that there. Okay, so... is there one down there? I really would like to know. There probably... no, there's just a jumping area there. Run! Push against the wind, Mario! Okay. So, what the heck kind of jump was that? Come on, Mario, work with me here. And if there's another, I mean, if I can find a propeller mushroom, I'll definitely take advantage of it and go back just to get that coin. I can't get the second coin, though, just yet, obviously, because I passed the... well, I could if I really went backwards, but eh. That's a lot of Koopas. And... what's in these things? Propeller mushroom? No, okay. Now, you'll notice that there's a block structure in that upper left corner of the screen. That's where the secret exit is, and you actually have to go over that structure. I'll show you how to do it, don't worry. But for now, I'm just gonna go to the exits, and hopefully the wind will work with me, or there'll be no wind at all. Okay, now I'm gonna be a little more careful just to get the propeller mushroom and get through the level safely, as well as collect those two coins. And the secret exit, of course. Ring! So let's go back to this. Yeah, there's another split path coming up. The level off to the right, the one that's on that mushroom, has a secret exit as well, which I'll be covering later, of course. And... yeah, there we go! Propeller mushroom for the win! Woo! I love the propeller mushroom. Even though it's not as broken as other items in the Mario series that let you fly, it's still pretty broken, I have to say. But it's an item, and it does have its own mechanics, since you know, you can't fly as far as you can with other flying items in other Mario games. So I guess it's not as broken, as I said. So, no piranha plant hits for me today, mister. No. I must get coin! Okay, let's try this again, this time with more success. Here we go! Yeah, baby! That's some mad skills! Okay, it's actually not that hard to do, I just kind of did it a little late the first time I did it. Okay, now with this coin here, you want a full gust of wind to get over there. Because you need that side, you need to be pushed far to the right side, otherwise you're just going to hit the ceiling. Okay, here we go. That's coin number three. Okay, now for the secret exit. What you have to do is try for a triple jump on this platform here. If you can, let's just see if I can. One. Will this work? No, not high enough. Yeah, I have to get over that wall there. And that's pretty tricky to do. You really have to get a high enough jump to get up there. And I've only done this once before, pretty much because I've only beat this game 100% once before, but... yeah, if I can do it once, I can do it again. Maybe I'll have better luck getting up there from over here, perhaps? Maybe? Could be? Possibly? Let's just wait for the gust of wind first off, and then try for a triple jump. Yeah, I forgot to mention you could triple jump like you can in Mario 64, or Sunshine if you, time your jumps well and while running at the same time, like you can... oh, maybe you can triple jump as... oh yeah, you can triple jump as Propeller Mario, my bad. So man, how do you get up there? I don't remember there being a secret block hidden around here somewhere. It just doesn't seem like I can get high enough from... yeah, I just can't seem to get high enough over there, but I know I got up there from this left side before, Maybe I just took a jump from over here? Let's just try from up here. Oh, that does work! Awesome! That's pretty easy to do then. I was just overcomplicating things. So there's your secret exit right there. And just jump along here, use your propeller. Obviously you need the propeller to even get up here. That's why they made that last obstacle course to the secret flag stick here. Propeller only, so to speak, if you want to get that one up. That would be easy to get even if there wasn't any platforms to lead you to it. And the secret exit leads to that pipe, which takes you all the way over to the castle like that. But I don't need to use the pipe, obviously, and since I'm going for 100%, that's completely useless to me, because I have to show all the stages, as well as the secrets in those stages. But as for now, I'm gonna end it off here, because there's more levels to come. I'm already 15 or so minutes into this part. Hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you later.